Hello students, welcome to UN College digital class. Myself Swarnalata Patra, lecturer in IT. Today I am going to discuss about what is e-commerce or electronic commerce security. Before going to start what is e-commerce security, let us first discuss about security. Security is an essential part over the internet. For example, when data transfer from one state to another state, data should not be lost and there should not be any change of data. To keep the data secure, there should be a security mechanism. Let us start. What is e-commerce or electronic commerce security? E-commerce security is the guidelines that ensure safe transaction through the internet. It consists of protocols that safeguard people who engage in online selling and buying of goods and services. You need to gain your customers' trust by putting in place e-commerce security basics. For example, when we purchase anything by using online store or virtual store, we need input some important data. Our bank information, like our CVV number, our account number, that is personal data. That should not be steal by others. So if that is hacked by others or steal by others, that is a great loss of the customer. So to secure this type of personal data or personal information, there should be a security mechanism to protect our data. If there is no protection mechanism, if there is no security, customer will lose his or her faith in the site. Following are the essential requirements for safe e-payments transaction. First one is privacy, next one is integrity, next one is authentication, and next one is non-repudiations. Let us first discuss what is privacy. Privacy means data should be kept personal, confidential. It should not be shared to others. Privacy includes preventing any activity that will lead to the sharing of customers' data with unauthorized third parties. Apart from the online seller that a customer has chosen, no one else should access their personal information and account details. A breach of confidentiality occurs when a seller lets others have access to such information. An online business should put in place at least a necessary minimum of antivirus, firewall, encryption method, and other data protection. It will go a long way in protecting credit card and bank details of clients. Then next one is integrity. Data integrity is defined as assurance, maintenance, and accuracy of data over the life cycle. For example, when a student takes admission in the college, his or her data first maintained in the college office, then in the departmental office, and then in the library also. If any change occurs in the name of the student, then there arise data inconsistency. If data inconsistency will arise, then data integrity will be not maintained. Integrity is another crucial concept of e-commerce security. It means ensuring that any information that customer have shared online remains unaltered. That means there is no change of data. The principle states that online business is utilizing the customer's information as given without changing anything. Altering any part of the data causes the buyer to lose confidence in the security and integrity of the online enterprise. And next one is authentication. The principle of authentication in e-commerce security requires that both the seller and the buyer should be real. They should be who they say they are. The business should prove that it is real, deals with genuine items or services, and delivers what it promises. The client should also give their proof of identity to make the seller feel secure about the online transaction. It is possible to ensure authentication and identification. If you are unable to do so, hiring an expert will help a lot. Among the standard solutions include client logins information and credit card pins. Authentication means there should be a mechanism to authenticate a user before giving him or access to permission to the database. Next one is non-repudiations. Non-repudiations means denial. Therefore, non-repudiation is a legal principle that instructs players not to deny their actions in a transaction. The business and the buyer should follow through online transaction part that they initiated. E-commerce can feel less safe since it occurs in cyberspace with no live video. Non-repudiation gives e-commerce security another layer. It confirms that the communication that occurred between the two players indeed reached the recipients. Therefore, a party in that particular transaction cannot deny a signature, email, or a purchase. Non-repudiation means protection against denial of payment or denial of order. For example, when a sender sends a message to the receiver, the sender should not be able to deny the sending message, and also recipient should not be able to deny the receipt. Next one is measures to ensure security. Major security measures are following. First one is encryption. Next one is digital signature. Next one is security certificates. Let us first discuss encryption. It is a very effective and practical way to safeguard the data being transmitted over the network. Sender of the information encrypts the data using a secret code, and only the specified receiver can decrypt the data using the same or different secret code. Next one is digital signature. Digital signatures ensures the authenticity of the information. A digital signature is an e-signature authenticated through encryption and password. And digital signatures are the public key primitives of messages authentication. In the physical world, it is a common to use handwritten signature on handwritten or typed messages. They are used to bind signatory to the message. Similarly, a digital signature is a technique that binds a person or entity to the digital data. This binding can be independently verified by receiver as well as any third party. So, digital signature is a cryptographic value that is calculated from the data and a secret key known only by the signer. Next one is security certificates. Security certificates is a unique digital ID is used to verify the identity of an individual, website, or a user. For example, a website security certificate is a digital stamp of approval from an industry trusted third party known as Certificate Authority, CA. It is a digital file containing information that is issued by a CA that indicates that the website is secured using an encrypted connection. Next one is Security Protocols in Internet. We will discuss here some of the popular protocols used over the internet to ensure secure online transaction. First is this protocol is the Secure Circuit Layer, SSL. Secure Circuit Layer, SSL, provides security to the data that is transferred between web browser and server. SSL encrypts the link between a web server and a browser, which ensures that all data passed between them remain private and free from attack. First one is Secure Circuit Layer, SSL. It is the most commonly used protocol and is widely used across the industry. It meets the following security requirements. First one is authentication, encryption, integrity, non-refutability. Next one, HTTPS is to be used for HTTP URLs with SSL, where HTTP is to be used for HTTP URLs without SSL. Next one is Secure Hypertext Transfer Protocol, SHTTP. SHTTP extends the HTTP Internet Protocol with public key encryption, authentication, and digital signature over the internet. Secure HTTP supports multiple security mechanisms, providing security to the end users. HTTP works by negotiating encryption scheme types used between the client and the server. Next one is Secure Electronic Transaction. It is a secure protocol developed by MasterCard and Visa in collaboration. Theoretically, it is the best security protocol. It has the following components. First one is cardholders digital wallet software. Next one is merchant software. Next one is payment gateway server software. Next one is certificate authority software. Let us discuss first cardholder digital wallet software. Digital wallet allows the cardholder to make secure purchase online via point and click interface. Next one is merchant software. Merchant software. This software helps merchant to communicate with potential customers and financial institutions in a secure manner. Next one is payment gateway server software. Payment gateway provides automatic and standard payment process. It supports the process for merchants' certificate request. Next one is certificate authority software. This software is used by financial institution to issue digital certificate to cardholders and merchants and to enable them to register their account agreements for the secure electronic commerce. Today I have discussed about what is electronic commerce security and about privacy, integrity, and authentication and non-repudiations. Thank you.